I'm Helena Irene Mikaelsen from Imperia, and you are now watching Liprog by Malzahn.
Some 20 years ago, Thomas Youngblood and Richard Warner founded the band Camelot. Now, I first heard of this band in 2005 when I reviewed The Black Halo. I must say, an album that to this very date I very much love. Over the years, Camelot has built up a very strong reputation, releasing very good albums, you know, having a bit of a brand of their own. Excellent live shows and a fantastic live DVD as well. Unfortunately, they had a setback in 2011. Unfortunately, singer Roy Khan left the band because of health problems. No worries, the band have a new singer and they are back with a very strong album, maybe their best album ever. This one, Silverthorn.
Like night without awakening.
From the moment I got this in my hands, I was impressed. I mean, look at the beautiful front cover. We have the rear with the track listing. It's a very luxurious digipack. So, the packaging already is very appealing. Now, if you're familiar with Camelot, you kind of know what you can expect. But before we go on to the music, let's look a little bit further into the cover. So, the artwork is very cool. Now, you've already seen the photos of the band, and you've also seen, of course, the new singer, Tommy Karavik, from the Swedish band Seventh Wonder. So, we still keep a Scandinavian singer in the band. Well, they kept in line with that. Now, a couple of things I noticed when I listened to the music, and I focused a little bit on the singer, of course, because I was very curious, you know, well, how is he going to sound on the album? People who are ardent followers of the band and have been to a lot of shows in the recent past may have seen Tommy already, because he did a guest spot already with Camelot. But now we have him on album. And I gotta say, if I look at the photos, I say he fits in very nicely. You know, he kind of almost looks a little bit like Roy Khan. But vocally, I am very impressed. This guy is a fantastic singer. And, well, to start with it right away, track number 5, Song for Jolie, is a ballad. But when you listen to that track, listen carefully. There you can hear how good, how awesome this guy is as a vocalist, you know? That song really blew me away.
There's a shadow in the cold white light of day. I hope that someday you'll forgive and set me free.
But on the whole album, I gotta say, it's very impressive. I can honestly say this is the best album I ever heard from Camelot. Everything just fits together so perfectly. When you listen to the song structures, the compositions are very good. And something very interesting I noted, I mean, often you have to... It's a very bombastic album, of course. It's symphonic, it's metal, it's proggy. It has everything to offer. And normally expect a long album. But when I looked at the total length of the album, we're talking 56 minutes. Now, I say that's a very modest time for an album like this. Most of the tracks are around 4-5 minutes, with one track lasting about 9 minutes, which is of course, the longest track on the album. And at the end, they do something, well, something strange. Continuum is the last track on the album. And when it ended, it ends like a minute and a half, and then you have silence. And I thought, well, this is it. But it turns out that you have to wait a while, and then you get, well, almost a minute of more music, but instrumental and very, I know, very religious sounding music. It's this religious sounding music appears in other parts of the album as well, and also has to do with the, well, story of the album. The story is about a young girl who dies in the arms of her twin brothers and takes, well, a secret with her into the grave. Now, that's a very mysterious kind of story, and also when you read the lyrics, you know, you feel things like loss, like guilt. There's a lot of emotion in the music, and I must say I'm very impressed how they also express that emotion in the songs. I gotta especially say kudos to Thomas Youngblood and Oliver Palotai for the way they compose the tracks, but also how they play together, how they complete each other in the tracks. It's very fantastic. So we have a fantastic lineup. I mean, we add, of course, Sean Tibbetts on bass, and we had Casey Grillo on drums on it. They work together so fantastic. It's a real well-oiled machine when you listen to the album. And despite the fact that it's less than an hour, it doesn't feel like that. It feels very organically. The flow is very natural in the songs. And wow, when you're finished, you want more. And you really will play it again. At least that's what I did. And I think everybody will, because this is really a fantastic album. Another thing that really stood out for me is the track Prodigal Son, the longest track on the album. It's almost 9 minutes long. The opening especially is very beautiful. The first part is like you were in a church and you hear those, you know, the really beautiful orchestrations by Oliver Palotai. And then when they end, you have Tommy Karavik coming in with vocals and added, accompanied by acoustic guitar. It's really beautiful, and again a demonstration of how well he sings. He has a fantastic voice. He fits absolutely perfectly in Camelot. He's absolutely a perfect successor to Roy Kahn. You know, he has the same kind of emotions and the same kind of sound to him, and well, that works very well on this album. And altogether, you know, they have proven that, well, they are absolutely the best in their genre with this album. They have a few guests as well, because when you listen to the album, of course, the Camelot style is very familiar. It's very bombastic. It's very epic. There are a lot of beautiful orchestrations in it by Oliver Palotai. Again, you know, I love this guy very much. I mean, he used to be basically the sort of session keyboard player for the live shows, but gradually he became more close to the band, and, well, eventually he just became a full-time member. And I think that's a very wise decision, because he adds a lot of good to the music of Camelot. They have some guest singers, especially in the first track. The second track actually, because the first track, Manas Dai, is a sort of overture, instrumental. But the first track, the first actual track, Sacrimony, also has some female grunts in it. Well, I have my doubts. I'm still getting used to that, but it's only a little bit, and okay, it sounds very nice. But they also have a female guest vocalist, and I have to look up the name because I don't know everything, of course. The guest vocalist is Elise Wright. I hope I say it correctly. Familiar collaborators, Sascha Paeth, Miro, play parts in the album. They have not only a choir, but they also have a children's choir, and I found an interesting name here, Anneliese Youngblood. She also does some nursery rhymes in it, and she also plays a part in the children's choir. And that also adds a lot of, well, epicness and bombastic and symphonicness I don't know if that's even a word, but nevertheless, you get my point. That's what added to the music, and I like those contributions. And the few guests they have on the songs, I see them as salt and pepper, because they add flavor and spiciness, although in some cases a little bit of sweetness to the music. Now, very nice altogether, a fantastic album, so all I can say is listen to it. There's also a deluxe version available, which has the entire album in an instrumental edition. So if you want to, you know, do some karaoke, please don't. But, you know, just if you want to enjoy the music alone, you can do that. But I really would suggest listen to the album as the band intended it, with Tommy Karavik, because I think he's a brilliant singer. Camelot, Silverthorn, enjoy it.